Right, Lenny, thanks for joining us. We're just having a wee chat off camera there about your injury, your time out. It must have been a frustrating time for you, but you look like you're delighted to be back in training and back on the pitch on Saturday as well.
Yeah, obviously 3 months has been very frustrating. Seeing the team maybe not performing to the best they can and not being able to help them was obviously the most frustrating part for me. But obviously, put that to bed now. I'm back fully fit and obviously no problems as of yet or no continued problems. So I feel good about myself and my game at the moment. So to get back in the pitch on Saturday was obviously an achievement for me. And obviously the road that was hard work to get to where I am. So no, just buzzing to get back, and the fact that we get the 3 points that made those minutes obviously extra special.
Were you pleased with your contribution when you come on Saturday? Did you feel a bit rusty or that?
No, to be fair, even as I was saying to you, like last week we went up to Dingwall, and as a player, if you're out for obviously a number of months, you're maybe concerned in the back of your mind is, am I going to be sharp, maybe need the game sharpness? Obviously fitness was there, and I felt good about my game and played that 45 minutes, and then to get 20 minutes I felt good again. So there's no concern for me in terms of like my sharpness, because I feel good about my game. So it's just about getting more minutes with the first team and building on that till now at the end of the season.
You mentioned there about the 3 points on Saturday. It was a vital game, and there was probably a wee bit of pressure going into the game as well, considering the form that we'd been carrying into it. But the boys played really well, and it was a really deserved victory in the end.
Yeah, I think it's a relief to get the 3 points, obviously for the players and for the fans as well, because previous weeks we've kind of performed the first half of games, first 60 minutes of games, and then dipped for whatever reasons, and it's not been good enough for obviously the fans that come out in their numbers. Saturday was obviously, it's good to see them go away for the game happy with smiles on their faces, gives them something to talk about, because obviously the previous weeks we've not been able to do that, and that's been disappointing from our part. So it was good to get the 3 points, and it's a vital 3 points considering I think the results went for us as well. So it was a good 3 points. We just need to build on that now and put it to bed and focus on Saturday.
Well, let's move on to Saturday then. It's a big game against the Ayr, the definite surprise package of the Championship this season. They've been doing really well up near the top of the table. But we do actually have a pretty decent record against the Ayr down at Somerset, so there's no reason why we can't go down there and look to take back all 3 points.
Yeah, I think we'll go by game plan. We'll work all week in training, work hard, and how we can expose our weaknesses, and obviously shutting out the likes of Shanklin. He's been on form for them as well. So we'll just work on our game plan to go there. We know the group of players that we have, if we obviously stick to our tasks, and then we can definitely get something from the game. We went down there, and it was disappointing the last time we visited Somerset Park, so we'll be looking to go there and obviously rectify that and get the win this Saturday, and obviously, as I said, build on the 3 points we've had there, because it's big games coming in from now to the end of the season.
You obviously had your 3 months out, and the manager's changed since then. Have you noticed any significant changes from what it was like under Alan to what it's like under Stevie?
They're just, obviously, they're individuals, so they have their strengths and the things that they think work for them. So as I said, obviously Alan, I played under Alan as well, so I have a lot of respect for Alan. We maybe didn't on the pitch perform to the levels that we maybe should have, but then when you look back, there was games where we were total dominant and we just weren't killing teams off and either losing the game or drawing the game. So just kind of looking at that aspect. But for Stevie Crawford's came in, and his backroom staff, Callum Davison and Greg Shields, have been terrific with me as well and keep me focused to get back into the team. And no, it's good. It's just, as I say, they have different strengths that they have, and they've definitely brought like kind of freshness, because they're kind of up and coming managers and coaches. So no, it's good. And Callum's obviously worked with Scotland as well. Greg's been away in America, so they have different kind of views of the game that they're all trying to congeal into one. So it's good for us players to learn off that.
And it's a busy period. We've got Ayr on Saturday, then Partick Thistle on the Tuesday. It's a really important run of fixtures. And I guess it's a cliche, but it's just about taking one game at a time and looking after ourselves.
Yeah, I think like the inconsistency that we've had this season, I don't think we can get too far ahead of ourselves, because any time we get a win and everything looks good and positive, we don't seem to build it up with a couple of wins, which is obviously important in this league. If you do that, you see yourself creeping up the table. So we can't really get too ahead of ourselves. We just need to take each game as it comes. Every game's difficult. every team in this league can beat each other, so you need to full focus on every game, not really think too far ahead, or if we win that game and then maybe we'll win the next game. You just need to focus everything, put all your energy into the one game, and obviously that's Saturday, so we don't really think about Tuesday until Saturday's finished and we have the 3 points, hopefully.
And finally, from a personal point of view, it'll just be about, as you said, getting more minutes in the first team and try to nail down a place in the starting 11 between now and the end of the season.
Yeah, just obviously try and impress every time. If the manager starts me on Saturday, if he brings me off the bench or whatever his thoughts are, then I'm just looking to do the best I can and chip in with whether it's goals, assists, or just helping with the work rate, or just seeing games out. At whatever stage I come on in the game, or if I start, then I'm just looking to do my very best. And the fact that I've been out, I'm obviously hungry and more driven to be success and be a success from now to the end of the season.